Back here this time up in the penthouse of the Penthouse Podcast. I'm Bill Michaels alongside Mike Clemens. So day two in the books. So what did we learn today?
Did you feel that? Did you feel that?
I felt the earth move under my feet.
We had an earthquake here today.
Wow, how about that, huh?
7.7 on the Richter scale. It's centered in Havana in Cuba. But everybody here felt the building shake a little bit.
So it was, I don't know, about 11:30 our time here. And it felt like the best way to describe it is if you're like on a bridge and a big truck goes over the bridge and you feel the bridge kind of wobble.
I thought, because I was on a second floor of the convention center, I thought, that's a truck going by, right?
Right.
They're loading something in, right?
And we thought maybe it was kind of a big forklift, big pallet or something on it, because you're thinking, how did a truck outside make the entire convention center move?
An earthquake.
So there you go. So we felt that a little bit today. That was the earth-shattering news or earthquaking news. But you had a chance to meet with the teams today a little bit.
I did. We talked to Patrick Mahomes, and I'm going to have an interview with him tomorrow where I just said, hey, what was it like when you guys played the Packers in the preseason and Andy Reid decided to bring in his old friend Brett Favre to talk to the Chiefs and to talk to Patrick,
you know,
because they're so similar in styles. And so I've got an interview with him on that. And he also talks a little bit about the day that he shot that State Farm commercial with Aaron Rodgers. But then, you know, there's all these other players, too, talking about on the Chiefs and how they're going to stop that 49ers run game, how they think that their speed, like Tariq Hill, can get past the 49ers secondary. And then just the flip side for the 49ers. Very confident team, very well-coached team that likes to run the football and things that they can physically out-challenge the Chiefs.
Had a great interview. In case you missed it, you can go to the podcast and check it out at BillMichaelSports.com. Greg Jennings was very frank today. And he even talks about how a lot of people, Packers fans, get mad at him about some of the things that he says. But he really talked about getting prepared to go back to Milwaukee, to go to a Bucks game, as if he was going to take a lot of grief from the fans. And he said it was nothing but love. They kind of understood where he was coming from. I think one of the coolest things of the night, or the day, that is that my day wrapped up, I had a chance to talk with Joe Buck a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
And talk with Joe Buck from Fox Sports, and I was asking what he thought of the Packers. And it was pretty interesting. You're going to have to listen to the show, but basically it was he knew they couldn't stop the run getting off the bus. So it was, but he had a lot of impressive things to say about the Green Bay Packers, a lot of impressive things. And then tonight, we had fun. Just go ahead, real quick, before we get into it, go ahead and take a listen and a sight and a sound as to what we experienced tonight. It was a great time. We had a blast over at the Port J, which is what it is, at the Port of Miami where the cruise ships come in. It was a little bit tough getting there because there was a train and a car accident. We sat in a car for an hour and 10 minutes to get there. But nevertheless, once we got there, we had some good food. We had some paella. We had some sliders. We had a really good taco bar. So we were happy.
Yeah, they've got public transportation in Miami, Miami Beach, but there's just more cars than ever before.
Yeah.
And they're all, it's unbelievable. Lamborghini, Rolls Royce. Mercedes are like the junk cars around here.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
It's incredible. The money. The Ferrari store is right down the street, as a matter of fact. And a Lamborghini store is two blocks over from where we're staying right now. So it's amazing. So we had a great time tonight. Tomorrow, it starts out even better. And we confirmed today that Mark Murphy, president of the Packers, is going to join us at the end of the week.
Okay.
Jordy Nelson's going to be here on Thursday. What do you got going on tomorrow?
Well, more time with the teams. And then the teams hit the field on Wednesday and Thursday to start practicing for Super Bowl 54. So there's a couple of guys. We'll see if they're 100% cleared of injuries.
And Hard Rock Stadium, they finished painting the fields today. They're putting a tarp down because they are expecting a little bit of rain on Friday. And the stadium is now going on lockdown. No one else is allowed near or inside Hard Rock Stadium. So that's it for the Penthouse Podcast. Different view tonight, but it's off of our same balcony. It's just the other side of the building. So we're having a blast.
Did you feel that? Did you feel that?
No, that was me. That was the taco bar.
Okay.
So we're going to go ahead and get out of here because we need to get out of here. Talk to you soon.